Your currency opens up the week near unchanged. That follows last week's 1.5% decline against the dollar. Recall last week we heard from the Fed chair. He talked about possibly less dovish rate cuts moving forward. That was followed by the much stronger than expected non-farm payroll, which vaulted the dollar higher along with treasury yields, and then saw the euro move lower. So the euro down about 1.5% last week. Today, we did see a bit of a decline down to 109.5, but it did rally back up to 109.75 to end the day, holding near unchanged from Friday's settle. Again, a big move last week, not so much to start the week out today. We do have inflation data coming out later this week. Likewise, geopolitical risks remain elevated. A lot of moving parts going on in these markets in a very short amount of time, seeing big moves. Again, seeing the euro move down 1.5% last week, but again, holding steady to start the week at 109.75 today. Now, what does this mean for volatility? Well, check out that CVOL index over at cmegroup.com. You will see the volatility opened up the week, nudging higher. Again, seeing those moves, not only how big they are, but how fast they hit the market. Seeing the dollar move higher and the euro move lower, as well as elevated geopolitical risks, has kept volatility near the highs. Lastly, let's talk about positioning. What are speculators doing? Well, as of last Tuesday, they were exiting their net long positions, a trend that had started about a month ago. Now, this comes after the Powell testimony, but prior to Friday's non-farm payroll. So opening up the week, the euro moves lower down to 109.5, but rallies back up to 109.75 to close out the day very close to unchanged from Friday's settle, with still looming inflation data and rising geopolitical risks.